Well, you're looking live right now at a utility pole that is on fire right here in Orange and 10th, just down the road from WWSB ABC 7 Studios. Fire department just kind of watching it right now as it burns itself out. Again, a utility pole on fire. We had a power surge here at the station, and apparently this was something to do with it. Electrical fire is hard to put out right away, obviously. But again, a utility pole on fire here in downtown Sarasota at 10th Street and Orange. I see the law enforcement and fire department just kind of watching it. Again, tough to deal with electrical fires and getting them under control. It appears to be a wire that's on fire all the way down to the ground. I'll zero in on it, zoom in a little bit, see if you can see that better. And there it is. A utility pole on fire now. Luckily, it's isolated from anywhere else. Close to it, there's nothing near it. So I imagine that's why the fire department's kind of letting it go here for the time being. It looked like they had it under control for a while, and then it just sparked back up. So you're looking live now at a utility pole that just started on fire. I haven't got the details on it yet from the fire department, but I know we had a power surge at our station just at around, I would say, 7:30 or so. So I think that's the time of the incident. There doesn't appear to be anything that may have started it as far as an accident goes or anything like that. Kind of interesting to see a utility pole start on fire just like that without any lightning around. No storms around here, some storms nearby. Maybe it just got overheated, as everyone else did today. Here comes another fire department. Oh, here comes an ambulance of some sort. I might go and move my perspective here a little bit. But it appears to be a spontaneous thing that happened. I don't see a generator nearby on that utility pole, which is kind of interesting. So if you're just joining us now, you're looking live at a utility pole that's on fire on 10th Street in Orange in downtown Sarasota. Fire crews are kind of standing by right now, just kind of watching it. It will probably burn itself out. More interesting to note is how the fire started and why it started. As I said, I don't see it. Well, there appears to be something on top of it. Maybe a breaker of some sort. Yeah, there is a breaker on top. Let's see what some of the comments are here. So I see someone said their TV and internet stopped working. This is an electrical fire, obviously. No lightning around. I'm standing way back here. Oh, a good 70 yards away from it. We'll kind of zoom in on the firefighters there, just kind of watching it right now. I don't think there's a lot you can do with an electrical fire. Power's been cut, obviously, so they'll more than likely let this burn out. Yeah, there appears to be a breaker on top right there where it's coming from. Oh, it's a transformer. Ooh, was that light? That was lightning off in the distance, I think. A squirrel eat the wire on the bottom. Yeah, there appears to be a transformer on top. It's a small one, though. It's not one of those big transformers that you would see. So, yes, there appears to be a transformer on top. No, we just happened to see this. Our power kind of went out at the station. And then all of a sudden, we got some reports of a fire on a pole. Here comes the fire department a little bit closer now, monitoring the situation. Apparently this thing is just under control. Like I said, they're going to have to just kind of watch it. They might douse it with some fire or some water right now. I've never seen anything like a transformer go like that, and then all of a sudden a fire start. A little unusual. So the oil drips down after it fails, huh? Yeah, they probably have to foam it. This is kind of an interesting thing. I see FPL now is here on the scene. They just pulled over here. I don't know if you can see them. A couple of FPL trucks are showing up now. Probably to cut power to this light pole, but you can see I will zero in on it a little bit more. Flames are getting a little stronger there. Not unusual, Charles E. Hancock says. I've not seen many poles on fire. I've seen transformers kind of go on flames, but not the actual pole catch on fire. Sherry Yoder says no air conditioner tonight. That's a tough thing considering how hot it's been. Wood is dry, yeah. Could make sense there. Karen Marie, this is at 10th Street in Orange in downtown Sarasota, North Sarasota of downtown. FPL is on right now. There's some big light poles and power going through here. You can see those other light poles. I might have to get some flames. I might have to turn this broadcast off so I get some flames for the news tonight. I'll be back with you, though, in a minute. Let me see if I can get some video of this with my camera here. Yeah, you can't put water on it, obviously, huh? Now, I'll stay on it live right now for a little while. Yeah, everyone seems to be okay. Firefighters just kind of standing by. Obviously, we got a hot wire here with that transformer. There's not a lot you can do in an electrical fire until you get the power cut off from the supply source. See quite a bit of ashes now coming down on this. Firefighters are standing by right here. So obviously, this is an electrical fire on one single pole. The pole is not near any structure. So I think they're letting this go by until they can burn itself out. They cut power to it and they may throw some foam on it. Who knows? We got Ray Collins on the scene now. He's going to go ahead and shoot the video, so I'll stay live with this broadcast. I like all the comments. Karen Sell says they can use foam, waiting for permission for FPL. Obviously, a little bit of a fire here on a pole, an electrical pole, FPL pole, with a transformer on top. It appears, from what I'm reading, that the transformer more likely failed, caught fire, and the oil is dripping down now. Ray Collins on the scene. He's got his gear.
I like Bob's fishing show the most.
There you go. Taking a more view. Oh, we got quite a few here live. 250. 50 or so fueling line purple on fire. Apparently the transformer on top ignited. Yes, SMA is safe. Long way away. In fact, the power is still on at SMA. SMA, Sarasota Military Academy. Sherry, keep us posted on the power outage there. Flames shooting up from the base of this power pole. FPL is now on site, checking this thing out. Oh, Audrey said she saw it and heard it, huh? Yeah, they make some strange sounds. I know when bad weather comes through and they start arcing. And they start going, they can generate some loud sounds. There is a power station right back here. Most of the power is restored. You know, it's interesting. I wonder if it is heat related. High temperature today, 91. No storms around to cool things down. Plenty of air conditionings. Air conditioners working overtime all day long. FPL is going to take it easy on this because there are a lot of power lines right here at this corner coming from that substation on Orange. We'll keep it here for a while, guys. Sally, this is at Orange and 10th Street. Orange and 10th. We got station one working it right now. Here comes FPL. They got the lift right there. I'm gonna get out of their way. We gotta hand it to these guys. Back that truck right up to the line. Maybe I'll move around to the other side, get a better perspective. Those bright lights shining, you can't see that much. Not sure how it started, but it could be heat related. We got another reporter here.
Hey, how are you?
How are you?
What do we know so far, do we think? That it's heat-related, possibly?
Well, that's what I'm speculating. I haven't heard. I haven't talked to him. But, you know, a lot of air conditioning is obviously on. Lack of rain, very hot temperatures. Looks like a transformer blew. That's what we're getting reports of. And then...
Yes, it did, because where I live, the transformer blew.
And then as the transformer blew, the oil from it leaked down onto the pole there and catching the pole on fire. They can't put water on it, obviously, because it's an electrical fire. So FPL here is probably going to cut the power lines.
So power will be going back out?
No, probably not. I mean, there's no power coming out of that transformer now, obviously. So they probably bypassed it already. I'm seeing reports that people are getting their power back on.
Yep, our power just came back on in Gillespie Park, but it's definitely...
Right. They got a way of rerouting the power around lines and transformers. I know that. Especially with the Sarasota substation nearby.
This is at 8th or 10th and Orange.
10th and Orange. I'm going to go ahead and go around a different perspective. That those lights are right in us.
The lights are getting rolled up. We're going to cross the
street facing
us.
Yes. Just extra coming in, I know. We had to change
it. We're trying here.
Looks like they got the foam hooked up to it. Yeah, they're going to put foam on it now. Here it comes. Could be water. It could be water. If they've got the power off there, they can use water, obviously. What's interesting to note is the FPL guy is up there spraying the water on it using the hose from the fire department. Well, it's a fire on a utility pole here at 10th Street in Orange. That's what's happened so far. Transformer appears to have gone, and then that transformer started the fire. Here comes the, not sure what they're using there. Looks like it's a foam hose. There it goes. And I imagine with the power cut to this, it's not going to reignite. No, it's not. There's a concrete pole there, yes. But there's a piece of plastic conduit, if you will, going down the side of it. And that plastic conduit appears to have ignited from the oil dripping down from the transformer. Yeah, they're taking care of business now. And it looks like the fire is extinguished. And now they're just doing some cleanup. The pole that it's on is concrete, but there appears to be some plastic conduit on the left-hand side of it, or the back side of it, that may have started on fire. So you're looking live at the FPL guy with the hose in hand, and appears to be not a water hose, but some sort of foam hose that they're using from Sarasota Fire Department. I'm sure it's Station 1. This is going to about wrap it up, I think, for tonight. I'm getting reports that power was out at Gillespie Park and areas nearby, and this is the reason why, right here. Kill the feed. Thanks, Bob. You mix foam with water and aeration. As they're telling me right now, I'm going to just back out a little bit. So, what's about your house? Really not much. Some people were still without power, but I think they're going to reroute this. And everything should be okay. All right, thanks a lot, folks. Looks like FPL guy is done here. And so are we. We'll see you at 11 o'clock with more information on this. A little bit of an exciting. We're done. Good job, FPL.
Good job,
and
FPL.
Sarasota
Good
Fire
job,
Department.
Fire Department.